One of the biggest questions I see come up for Lightning node operators is the question of how they can access their node remotely so they can benefit from actually using their node in day-to-day commerce, such as spending on the Lightning network without actually putting all their funds at risk. In this video, I'm going to explain a new and I think pretty clever way for limiting your risk and exposure, not putting you in any danger physically or financially while using your node wherever you are in the world. Stick around. Greetings, Honey Badgers, Jonathan Levy here, and I'm really excited to share today's video with you because it's something that I have had a problem with for a very, very long time. You see, as node operators, we not only want to route sats and use our nodes to build the Lightning network, but of course, one of the main reasons we want to run a Lightning node is to be able to use the Lightning network in a non-custodial fashion. What's the point of having your very own Lightning node if you still have to rely on a custodian such as Wallet of Satoshi or Blue Wallet when you are out and about on the go? And with more and more places accepting Lightning network, and more companies starting to use this payment infrastructure, I know that I personally really want to be able to use my node on the go wherever I am in the world. Now, up until now, this has been a little bit of a challenge for a lot of various different reasons. Most of us still run our nodes solely on the Tor network or the Onion routing network, which makes it really, really slow and quite challenging, honestly, to use our nodes for a couple different reasons. Number one, as I mentioned just now, Tor is really, really slow. And number two, accessing the apps does require a Tor browser, which does not come default on any of our devices. Now, up until recently, really the only solutions for this were either to take your node on the clearweb and expose the IP address to the clearweb, which presents its own series of challenges, or there are some apps out there like Zeus, which will access your entire node on the Tor network. Now, there are a couple of problems with this. First and foremost is that personally, I haven't been able to get Zeus to work for many, many months. Well, there have been a ton of attacks and DDoS attacks happening on the Tor network for months and months and months at the time of this recording. And as you can see, my node never connects. I haven't been able to get it to connect a single time through Zeus. Meaning that basically, whereas in the past I could use Zeus to pay and use my actual node, now I haven't been able to. But that's not the only problem, because you see, when you use this, or even if you connect through the Telegram app, or if you use a Tor browser and actually connect to your node over Tor, you are connecting to your entire node, which means you have access to the full amount of your funds right on your node at any given time. And that's a huge risk, because if someone were to, God forbid, kidnap you, steal your phone from your hand while you were using it, your entire node and all the funds on it are exposed. And I don't know about you, but as you can see when you browse my node on Amboss, I've got a lot of funds on my node, and I really don't want to expose all of them and put myself or my funds at risk. And that's why I'm so excited about today's video and the solution that I'm going to be presenting to all of you. Now, you may remember in a past video, I talked a lot about LNBits and how it is the single most powerful app for your Bitcoin Lightning node. If you haven't seen that video, please check it out here. You can pause this video, open a new window so that the YouTube algorithm doesn't penalize me for you leaving this video in the middle. But for those of you who haven't watched the video and want to save some time, LNBits is basically an app that allows you to create subwallets and become a wallet infrastructure provider for yourself, your family, or in the case of the project that I'm going to be doing with Voltage and members of the Kwame Spurksproot Village in South Africa, entire communities. By the way, this video is brought to you by my friends over at Voltage. Yes, technically, with the method that I'm explaining today, you could host your very own BTC Pay server and access it on the Clear Web, so that you could do commerce and actually accept payments on your node and run a business over your node. But let's be honest, if you're focused on actually running a business, building something out for the Lightning network, or doing enterprise-grade commerce on your Lightning node, well, then probably running a Raspberry Pi over the Tor network is not going to be fast enough or efficient enough, and that's probably better for side projects and farmers market commerce. If you want to run an enterprise-grade node available anywhere on Earth, no matter where you travel,
connected to your website or business or your Lightning app, you probably need something like Voltage. Voltage makes it incredibly easy to set up and operate your node, and they even offer a paid service where they will manage liquidity, balance channels, open channels, and closed channels for you so that you can focus on running your business and not just running your node. Set up your node incredibly quickly and easily. Visit them today at the link in the description or visit voltage.cloud. All right, let's get back into the video. Now, I mentioned in that video that in order to make this work over clearweb and not just your local internet or Tor, you would need to have a reverse proxy solution, meaning something that is going to connect the clearweb to your Tor address and create that interface. And I did mention that I had done this by setting up a reverse proxy on a cheap service provider called RackNerd and how you could do that, but how even I had to get a professional to help me set that up. And all that is well and good, but today I have something much cooler to present to all of you. I mentioned in that video as well that LNBits was working on a paid solution for those who are not tech savvy, where they would give you a reverse proxy, and that the makers of Citadel are actually doing the same thing. And as of today, that solution is now available. It's really, really affordable. I think somewhere between $1 and $3, depending on how many apps you want to provide on the Clear Web. And by the way, I'm not getting anything except a demo free version of this service to present it to you. I earn no commissions. I just want to support the project and see more and more people using their own Lightning nodes in day-to-day commerce. So that's my disclosure on my interests here. But I really quickly want to walk you all through the experience and some of the benefits and why this is such a cool thing for you to be able to access your node. Now, the first thing is just in order to set it up, all you have to do is go to sats4me.com, purchase the service, and as of right now, you will be given a random URL at runcitadel.com. Now, it's important to note this will work for Umbrel, for RaspiBlitz, for Citadel, for any of the node providers. And you can run either BTC Pay or LNBits or both. So if you want to have a payment terminal set up in your business or at your, you know, local farmer's market, and you also want to use the LNBits wallet for all the various benefits I'm going to be presenting throughout this video, you can do that. Really, really cool service. Once you set it up, and maybe when I get back to the studio in front of a computer, I will show you all. But once you get that set up, you'll be given a random URL. For example, my node, and I think you can actually connect to my node and set up a wallet on my node if you want to. I don't mind, but why would you custody on my node? You can go to this website right here that I'm showing on screen, and we will demonstrate here. By the way, I'm about 3,000 kilometers away from home right now, as you can see, on vacation. So it really is going to be a good test of the speed of this service and how well it works. Once you have this set up, you can go to the URL that Citadel gives you. In my case, it's proxy-demo.runcitadel.space, and it will ask you to set up your LNBits on Citadel wallet. Now, you may be tempted to want to put in here, I have an admin password, but I want you to not do that for this specific wallet that you're going to be setting up, because the whole idea here is to limit the features and functionality that you have access to while you are traveling or while you are on the go. And the reason we want to do that is for safety. Like I said, if you want to have access to your entire node, you're presenting yourself with a lot of security holes and the ability for people to do a lot of stuff that you don't want to do. And so while you could set it up with an admin password here and get access to all of the apps that I talked about in that previous video, personally, for my own mobile LNBits setup, I have not entered in an admin password. Now, all you have to do here, and by the way, this could be you, this could be your spouse, this could be your kids, this could be your friends. Every single person just needs to enter in a unique wallet ID. And once you do that, you hit add a new wallet, and you can see 3,000 kilometers away from my node over the Tor network, it is automatically going to route that traffic to my node, which is in my own custody, not on a cloud server, and set up this wallet. It's then gonna tell you that right now they don't have login functionality. So the only way to save this wallet is to bookmark it with the unique ID that is in the URL. We can really quickly look at that, and you will see there is a unique ID in there. That is the only way for you to preserve the funds that you put in this wallet. So you really need to copy that URL. You really need to save it somewhere. Again, if you lose that, these funds are custodied on your own node.
But if it comes to you giving it to someone else and you want to keep a record of that wallet and they want to keep their funds and be able to withdraw them, it's really important that you copy that URL, bookmark it, write it down, print it out, whatever. And that's it. That's all we have to do to create a wallet. And we then have a nice limited functionality wallet that you can use to receive, paste, scan. And what's cool about LNBits, as I mentioned in the previous video, it is LNURL capable. It works with things like LNURL POS, LNURL withdraw, and all these other incredible features that honestly some of the best wallets out there don't yet support. You also can go into the admin dashboard on your computer when you're at home and actually manage through your node some of the preferences and what you want to allow people who are set up with non-admin passwords to do, what extensions you want to allow them to use, and on and on and on. But it's really cool because you can set up a lot of these things like payment servers, like a POS, and you're not putting your entire node at risk. You'll see here, the only funds I have available to me are the ones that have been deposited into this wallet. Now, for demonstration purposes, because I am traveling, I've actually gone ahead and set up another wallet that I want to show you all how to use. But just for your understanding, all you have to do if you want to add this mobile wallet, you don't even need to download an app here. All you have to do is save it as a bookmark to your home screen like this, add to home screen. I believe there's a similar functionality on Android, and you will be presented with LNBits. You then have a mobile wallet, and let's see how fast this loads. Really freaking fast, honestly. You then have a mobile wallet that is set up, and you can see that I have loaded this with 83,000 sats. I can, of course, change my theme, how I like it, how it should look. And I now have a fully functioning wallet right on my phone with only 83,000 sats. So if someone were to steal my phone, if they were to kidnap me and hold me at gunpoint, please don't do that because I don't have access to my own Bitcoin. But even on my phone, I only have access to 83,000 sats. I can then paste, receive. If I want, I can send from other services. I can send from exchanges and just receive. Or you can even send from your own node through here. I've had some people tell me that they had difficulty doing that, that ThunderHub doesn't want you to pay an invoice, but I was able to do it right from the Citadel interface. I just created an invoice and sent it to myself. There are lots of different ways you can get sats onto this wallet, but what's cool about it is I only have 83,000 sats at risk here. So really, really cool way to do this. And as you can see, it works really, really fast. Any extension that I add, it adds it quickly. LNURL Pay, if I want to set up a Bitcoin payment credit card, a physical card that's connected to this wallet, they have that feature built into the latest version of LNBits, which, by the way, let me know in the comments below, would you guys like to see how I created my own physical Bitcoin Bolts 12 payment card that I can tap to pay with NFC that's connected to my node? Because I've been thinking about doing a video there, but I don't know if that's something you all are interested in. So please let me know in the comments below. And of course, make sure you're subscribed so that if I do come out with that video and you guys all do want to see it, you let me know. So like I said, fully functioning wallet. And what's cool is I can just reload this wallet from my own node as I go along without needing to put my entire node at risk. I do not have the ability here to close channels, send on-chain payments, or do anything that could put my funds or me at risk of physical harm or loss of funds. I have full access to tons of extensions. And even if you're on Android, I can actually use NFC to pay. I know iPhone does not allow this mobile kind of web interface app to use the NFC reader. Hopefully that's something that will change in the future, but that's it. And that's how I've been using my node recently, how I've been depositing funds onto my node. They are in a separate sub account right on LNBits. And so with that, I think it's time for me to remove Zeus, which hasn't been working for me for probably 6 months anyway. And if you would like to try this service out for yourself, as of right now, I believe the service is free for anyone who wants to try it out. Do some beta testing for the folks over at Citadel. You can do that by visiting sats4.com. me. So I really hope you've enjoyed this video. It's been a really, really quick tour de force of my preferred method of accessing the funds on my node and actually being able to use my node on the go as a mobile wallet without putting myself or any of my significant Lightning Network funds at risk. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know in the comments below of another video that you would like me to do. Make sure that you like and subscribe and consider supporting the channel by joining as a member. I look forward to making more videos like this for all of you. Take care.